So let's talk about work in progress for construction. If you were recording your work in progress through a manual journal entry process, Sage Intacct now has a WIP management tool that helps automate that journal entry and helps automate the amounts that you will be using for the contract and the estimate prices. So basically, if you're creating or have a work in progress schedule, either in Intacct or if you're using even another system and you're interested in Intacct, you're doing this in Excel, right? You're going to have your project contract price, your project estimate, your billings, your costs, and your over-under calculation based on your percent complete. So what can happen in work in progress booking of that journal entry is that I've got some billings that are greater than my contract price. So in red here, showing this, that I am over, my billings exceed my contract price. You cannot do that in a work in progress calculation. Or if your job to date costs exceed your project estimate. So I can't be over 100% complete on a project. So in order to help manage these types of numbers that where, you know, my project contract price is not high enough compared to my billings, I'm done with a project or I don't want to go in and manually adjust, you know, this estimate up to get to my job to date costs. I just want to book this at 100% complete and adjust my numbers through this WIP management tool I will show next. That is the purpose of using the WIP management tool, is to help in these situations to adjust the numbers. If you are not going to rely on the project contract or project estimate number, that might not be up to date in your WIP reporting. Okay. The other scenario would be your project manager is estimating a different number than what you think as the controller or CFO, what you think the project is really going to do. Okay. So before I jump into the WIP management tool, do want to clarify, you do want to keep your project estimate, your project contract as up to date as possible, or your project managers or your project admins should. Okay. So let's not lose sight of that. However, if you want to make some adjustments to these numbers because you know you need a contingency amount for some issues on the job, you know, above and beyond what it shows here for your estimate, that's kind of the purpose of the WIP management tool. Okay. So I'm going to come over here to show the WIP management tool. And so what occurs in Sage Intacct is you're going to come into these WIP project settings and you're going to set your projects to be included on this WIP management tool. So in essence, when I hit the create button here, I am going to have a list of projects and do I want them to be included in my WIP calculation or do I not? So the WIP management settings is where you're going to go in and WIP project settings, where you're going to go in and set those projects up. Okay, so I'll go into that here in a second. So basically, your WIP schedule, you're going to pick the month that you are going to be doing your WIP, and you should do these in sequence. So you should do June before you do July, for example. Okay, so now what it's doing is listing out my projects. I've got errors and warnings that I need to resolve. And I have some amounts to review here. Okay. So basically, what's going to happen is my estimate is going to come in from the project estimates area right here, including any change orders, including any revisions. Okay. My total contract value is going to come in from my project contracts, including any change orders and any revisions to the contract value price. So these are the revised contract values and revised estimates. Okay, but let's say the CFO knows that I'm going to be needing another $500,000 on this estimate so that I can reserve some for some issues on the job. Okay. But the CFO doesn't want to go into the project manager's project estimate and necessarily adjust their estimate and their numbers. Okay. But in the WIP, they want to account for it. So basically what you can do is take this number here and add $500,000 to it. Okay. So as an example, the contract value, same thing. You could adjust this up or down if you think that there is a potential change order coming that's going to be a deduct, for an example, for some sort of money you're giving back to the owner, you know, another example. Okay. So what you can easily do is you can update the CFO values with the project manager values like this. I've clicked my project over here. And now let's say I want to add $500,000 to this. I'm just going to hit the plus sign in my keyboard, type 500,000, hit enter. And now I've just brought that cost, estimated cost at completion, up 500 grand. Okay. Same thing you could do in this field as well. Also, you can play with the percent complete if you'd like as well. I like to actually play with the numbers here, or adjust these numbers here, and not do the percent complete over here. Then you've got your static columns, which cannot be adjusted because these are actuals. So your actual job to date costs, your actual job to date billings, and your year to dates as well. Okay, you can put a comment over here, adjusted estimate for 500 grand due to issues on job. Okay. So you can comment some things over here. And then let's say I agree with the rest of the projects and I want to make the estimates. I want to bring the estimates and the contract value over from what the project manager has recorded in the system. Okay. So now all my errors are gone. I don't have any warnings either. I am going to then finalize my WIP entry. To easily finalize all of them, I'm going to checkmark all, hit finalize. And now I can see that my finalize has turned to yes. These were all no a second ago. I'll shrink my screen down a second. You can see everything on one. Okay. So now I've got no errors, no warnings. I'm finalized. And now I want to save my WIP entry. Okay. So now I have my WIP entry saved here. And best practice, obviously, I would have these other ones posted first. Okay. So I'm just going to show you how to post an entry now. So it's going to create the over-under billing at this point. So once I save my values, I'm going to come back to the screen. I'm going to hit this edit, these dots over here. I'm going to hit edit. And I'm going to hit post. There's a warning on here, but I should still be able to get through that. And it's going to say the posting date. Do I want to automatically reverse my WIP entry? So it's going to ask you the reversal date. Normally, you are going to do the first of the following month. You can put a description here, edit this if you'd like. Otherwise, you're just going to hit submit. And now my entry has been posted. Okay, so now let's go look at the journal entry. So we're going to view it. And now I'm going to go to posting history over here. So notice my values are all frozen, okay, based on what I saved. So here's my 430 entry and here's my 51 reversal entry. So let's go look at the 430 journal entry, and you could see it's crediting my billings in excess And it's also tagging the project and it's debiting my net over under billings on my income statement. So the reversal entry obviously is going to do the opposite here. So basically on the WIP schedule, you can drill back down into your journal entries. You can see the frozen amounts so you know what you actually recorded for your over under. And you can have that in your posting history as well. It tags that project on there. So you might be doing a journal entry now where it's not tagging the project specific. It's just a general credit to billings in excess of costs and debit to over under. And it's not tagging that project level. Okay. So this actually does more detail through the WIP management tool. So now I'm just going to show you the WIP management settings briefly here on how you're going to tag those projects to include on the WIP management tool there. So we're on the WIP project settings. I'm going to click on the project here. And you can see this include data and WIP schedule. So that means it's going to include it on the WIP management tool here. Also, you could go to the project list and turn on the checkbox as well. So you can do it both ways from WIP project settings or the projects list. Okay, one more setup item I want to show you is you're going to go into configuration here to set up your cost, your revenue, and your net over under billing account that the journal entry is going to post to. So down at the bottom here, there's a new section that you're going to pick your cost accounts, your revenue accounts, where the billings and the costs get coded to. You're going to assign your costs in excess and your billings in excess account, your net over under billing, and the journal that you're going to use. If you need to set up this journal, you're going to go to General Ledger Journals, and you're going to set up the WIPJ journal if it's not already set up. Okay. So any questions on getting this set up, how to use the WIP management tool, please reach out to us and we will help you get set up properly and show you how to use this WIP management tool and also go through any best practices with you. Thank you for your time today and we hope you enjoy the automation of WIP.